I know. Yep. Okay. You can sit anywhere. Okay. Check. Yeah. Are you sitting here? Okay. Here, I'll move this here. And you sit here, and I'll hand this to you when we're ready.
Check two.
Richard and I got this ritual before we get going. That's what it's going to do. Good morning. I know it seems evening on this side of the world, but somewhere, as Brother Jim would always say, it's morning somewhere.
That's right.
Thank you, Brother Peter, for an outstanding meal. Ugh, moly, I'm going to be moving slow from that. Thank you for joining us. We are going to mix things up. Instead of doing evening prayer, we are going to be doing morning prayer or lauds. It helps to just get a good, rounded feeling for the other aspects of prayer life for the Order of St. Luke. With that, I hand it over to you, Brother David.
Please stand. O God, open our lips.
And our mouths shall
proclaim your praise.
From the rising of the sun until its setting,
we praise your name, O God. By word and by water, God renews us this day in the living fountain of God's grace and raises us with Jesus Christ to live a new life in the Spirit.
Satisfy us in the morning with your steadfast love, O God, that we may sing for joy and be glad all our days.
Remember your baptism and be thankful. Brother Richard, if you would sprinkle people with water while we sing.
Dies in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King. Salvation, trusting his promise, faithfully now God's praises we sing. Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, dead in the tomb. In water, sealed by the Spirit, marked with a sign of Christ our King, born of one Father, we are his children. Joyfully now God's praise we sing. Come, let us sing to the Holy One. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before God's presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout with song.
For you, O God, are a great God. You are great above all gods.
In your hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are yours also.
The sea is yours, for you made it, and your hands have molded the dry land.
Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before God our Maker. For you are our God, and we are the people of your pasture, and the sheep of your hand. Oh, that today we would hearken to your voice.
The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
Dawn from on high, your light illumines all our days. Awaken us to your visitations throughout this day. Be merciful in us for the sake of others. Make us fearless when confronting injustice and need, and that we may give you glory in the power of the Spirit.
Amen. Mighty Adonai is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Israel. God is our refuge and our strength, who from of old has helped us in our distress.
Therefore we fear nothing, even if the earth should open up in front of us, and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea.
Even if the earth's waters rage and foam, and the mountains tumble with its heaving,
there is a river whose streams gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
God is in its midst, it will never fail. God will help it at daybreak.
Though nations are in turmoil and empires crumble, God's voice resounds and it melts the earth.
Mighty Adonai is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Israel.
Come see what Adonai has done. the wonders God has done on earth.
God has put an end to war from one end of the earth to the other, breaking bows, splintering spears, and setting chariots on fire.
Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted upon the earth.
Mighty Adonai is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Israel. Glory to you, O Trinity, most holy and blessed.
One God now and forever. Amen.
Mighty Adonai is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Israel.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 10, verses 19 to 25. Therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the holy places by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is, through his flesh, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. Let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. Holy wisdom, holy word.
Thanks be to God.
Hear what the Spirit is saying.
Please stand for the Canticle of Zechariah.
Please Adonai, God of Israel. For you come to visit us and ransom us from bondage. You have brought forth a strong deliverer in the house of your child David. This is what your holy prophets announce: deliverance from enemies and from the hand of all who hate us, mercy among our ancestors, and remembrance of your holy covenant. This is the solemn oath you swore to our ancestor Abraham, to make us unafraid, to rescue us from our enemies, to serve before you, holy and just, all the days of our lives. And this my little child shall be called prophet of the Most High, going before you, Adonai, to prepare your paths. He will make your people know deliverance by the forgiveness of their sins. Through your merciful compassion, God our God, the dawn from on high shall visit us, to shine on those kept in dungeons and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the paths of peace. Glory be to you, O Trinity, most holy and blessed, who is now, ever was, and ever shall be, unto endless ages. Amen.
We are all in this together, a reflection by Pastor Jack Peters. Let me state the obvious. The words we and us are plural words. They include me and whoever else I am talking to or about. One thing I learned from my mom and my dad was that when one family member had a need, we all had a need. When one family member rejoiced and celebrated, we all celebrated. When one family needed help, we helped. Without saying the exact words, Mom and Dad communicated, we are all in this together. The recipients of the Book of Hebrews were struggling. They were probably second generation Jewish believers, some of whom were being tempted to go back to the old Jewish ways. I feel that most of them were true Christians in hard circumstances, tempted to leave the faith. We do not know who wrote the book of Hebrews, but it is obvious the author knew them well. He addresses them in the passage as us. Three times he says, let us. He's implying they were all in this together. In some ways, we are like those Hebrew believers of old. The pandemic, racial unrest, the generational isolation might be tempting us to be involved in our Christianity more on the sidelines than as active participants. We are often victimized by fear and worry. I believe that the author of Hebrews gives us help in remembering that we are all in this together as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
sisters and brothers. In peace, let us pray to the Lord for our needs and for the needs of the world and for the prayers written in our prayer intention book.
For all whom we love, watch over, and for whom we care, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all prisoners and captives and those who suffer from oppression, that you will manifest your mercy towards them and make all hearts as merciful as your own. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all who bear the cross suffering, the sick in body or mind, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all those who are troubled by sin or suffering of those they love, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all who are absorbed in their own grief, that they may be raised to share the sorrow of others and know the saving grace of the cross, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all perplexed by the deeper question of life and overshadowed with doubt, that your light may guide them, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all who are tried by temptations or weakness, that your mercy may be their strength, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all who are lonely and sad in the midst of others' joy, that they may know you as their friend and comforter, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For the infirm and aged, and for all who are dying, that they may find their strength in you and live in your light at evening time, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
For all forgotten by us but dear to you, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
The Holy One be with you.
And also with you.
O God, by whom we are guided in judgment, and who raises us up for us light in the darkness, grant us, in all our doubts and uncertainties, the grace to ask what you would have us do, that your spirit of wisdom may save us from all false choices, and in your straight path we may not stumble. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear our prayer and let our cry come to you for Sister Elizabeth, our abbot, for the officers of the General Chapter, Brother George, Sister Jeanette, and Sister Heather, for our priors, for our brothers and sisters in the order, for a sense of community with others in the order, for grace to live for you and with each other in faithfully living out our rule of life and service, merciful God,
hear our prayer.
Compassionate God, hear our prayers, answer them according to your will, and make us channels of your infinite grace. Through Jesus Christ we pray.
Amen.
Let us join together in the prayer for the Order of St. Luke.
O Shepherd of us all, who inspired your servant St. Luke the physician to set forth in the gospel the love and healing power of Jesus, grant, we ask you, your Spirit to the Order of St. Luke, that we may proclaim the apostolic hope, magnify the sacraments, and embody Christ's healing grace for all creation, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen.
Gracious God, we pray for your holy church. Fill it with all truth, in all truth, with all peace. Where it is corrupt, purify it. Where it is in error, direct it. Where in anything it is amiss, reform it. Where it is right, strengthen it. Where it is in want, provide for it. Where it is divided, reunite it. For the sake of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior.
Amen.
No.
of love, and still is ours today. Oh, may this gracious God through all our life be near us, with ever joyful hearts and blessed peace to cheer us. Preserve us in His grace and guide us in distress, and free us from all sin till heaven we possess. All praise and thanks to God the Father now be given, the Son and Spirit blessed, who reigns in highest heaven. Eternal triune God, whom earth and heaven adore, for thus it was, is now, and shall be evermore.
The God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, establish and strengthen us by the power of the Holy Spirit, that we may live in grace and peace.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with us.
Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you all. Thank you all for the meal. Thank you for the singing. We've got the first lauds out of the way. I think that's good. Thank you, Brother Jim, for playing. Thank you, Brother, for sprinkling water. So we're going to adjourn, and we're going to discuss Chapter 8 of Food for Pilgrims. Thank you. We'll see you in the next room.